Hello everybody, Jesse James here. Welcome back to American Truck Simulator. I have done a little work. Let's see, where am I now? Oh yes, I am in Milwaukee. Came all the way across the states from, I think it was Oklahoma City, I think I went to, did I go all the way there or did I go from Santa Fe to Oklahoma City? I can't remember. I don't know. Anyways, so see what jobs are available. Let's see. Ooh, 19,000. But let me guess. I gotta go. Yeah, that would be probably a decent job if I wasn't all the way across the country. Come on, people. Like. And that's still a long ways to go. I could do that. Even though it's a mobile barrier, which is one of those long suckers. Actually, that actually doesn't look bad. Where am I going to? Back to Tulsa? You know what? Let's do it. It's only 17,000? Sure. Alrighty. Kick this sucker on. Where am I going? Look at my map real quick. Alrighty. I did change my recording key, so it's no longer zero, so you don't have to see the underside of my truck every time I hit the mic recording button. So yeah, it's actually the control key now. Oh, I better slow down. Oh, and I turned off the all the speed infringement things, even though I'm still gonna follow the laws, but like, since they don't have some laws actual in the game that are actually real, like turning right on red and stuff like that, I'll do that, but I won't be just blazing right past, right through intersections and whatnot. And, yeah. Which way do I go? I go left here. Oh, jeez. Sorry, dude. Can I make a turn before he gets here? Yes. Awesome. This is actually where I just came from. I think. Yep. Really? There's a bed right next to it? The whole time? I didn't even see that. I even looked on the map too. Oh, jeez. Whoops. Went around that curve way too fast. I'm going way too fast. Let me slow way down. There we go. Still going way too fast. I think I need to turn in here. Yep, this was it. Came on into bitumen. Okay. I'm committed. Let's pick her up. Where's she at? Where's it? There it is. Yep. I was like one space over where I delivered it to. Boy, was it cramped. It took forever. I was bouncing off of everything in this place. I was actually, I think I was maybe an hour late because I actually had to stop and sleep. Oh. There we go. Then I had to back way off over here to my left, and there was a vehicle. Or there's a trailer right here where I am, and a long one at that. I think it might have been a one of those barrier things too. And boy, it took forever. I think by the time I was finally got it in, I was several hours late. Since hours are like 5 minutes in this game. Okie dokie, let's go left. No one's coming. Nope, there comes someone. Sticking out. Oh well, let's go. There we go. yesterday. That's the only reason why I didn't record. It's green light, so I can go. I ended up taking the blades and the belt off of my mower because I was getting it ready to for this season. My riding lawnmower, and the belt was actually okay. It was actually in great shape for being used for 4 years. Come on, dude, you are just going slow. And of course the blades, they had worn down to, like, they were still sharp, but the back end, like the opposite edge that the blade was on, how it's supposed to, like, angle up, that whole little arch was completely gone. It actually looked like a kind of like a shuriken kind of, or some kind of throwing weapon, because it was just the ends of the blades just went to a point, and they were super sharp. You could cut a, if you laid a hair on the blade, you could easily cut it. And I had to be careful not to cut my hand wide open, or cut my hand at all. While I held the blade and then used the socket wrench to untighten it from the factory tightness, which was insane. Sorry, I forgot about that. I'm distracted as I'm chatting. I hate how they have, you would think they would have changed that whenever they added, you know, the Coast to Coast DLC, or the person that made the Coast to Coast thing, they would have made the on-ramp little, where you slow down to merge on, the merge lane basically longer, but apparently they didn't care about that, so, oh well. Let me stay in my lane. I am realizing this new key for my microphone, to talk, or whatever, push to talk, is not a good, I thought it was, but no. I'm using my pinky right now, and it's starting to hurt already. So, I'm gonna try to make this trip as quick as possible. And if I don't talk for large amounts of times, it's probably because I'm giving my pinky a rest. Oh wow, oops. I need to abide by the speed laws. I'll go 68, even though I'm not going to get any tickets or any kind of violation ticket, because I turned that off. I am still going to abide by the laws and try to go to the speed limit. And off camera, whenever I'm doing runs, I do go as fast as the truck will go, but I'm just gonna, you know, skip everybody over here. I actually try to stay in the lane as much as possible, but yeah. So far, I think I've only done, like, I think between this episode and last recorded episode on American Truck Sim, I've only done, like, one run. And I think it was like 17,000, and I only got like 13 because I ended up hitting some cars and whatnot. It was a pretty rough route. Well, I was pretty rough on my truck. Well, not too rough, but I had stopped to get gas and to, like, explore a few cities along the way, and just craziness happened, as it always does. Dude, this fire truck. The sound may be a little lower or higher. I actually turn the sound, of course, I turn the sound back up whenever I'm doing the non-recorded runs, and then I have to turn it back down so that you can actually hear my voice on my recorded runs. And I've actually got back into modded Minecraft. I started trying to figure out, because I've always wanted to make my own, like pick my own mods or whatever, and install them myself instead of using like a mod loader or whatever, or a mod pack. Because there's a lot of mod packs out there that they will literally make your computer perform like it's a a little single core computer. Don't know what that sound was. But yeah. There's some that here I've got a really good computer that can, handle a lot of things. Like as you have probably seen, I have actually recorded like Space Engineers while uploading a video. And even though it'll lag a little bit, it's actually playable. Because my computer can actually handle it, even though the GPU may be at 100%. And that's not, I don't actually physically have, I haven't changed the overclock settings. It may be factory overclock, but I haven't actually overclocked it more from there. Which, I actually did a little, kind of played around with that through a software suite that came with my graphics card. And it actually, that'll actually help whenever I am, like playing a very, graphics intensive game and uploading or processing a video. And once my GPU reaches 100%, I can or just before I start recording a new one, I could just ramp it up, turn the speed, the fan speed up. Usually I'll just turn it up to 100% to keep the heat down. I would love to liquid cool my graphics card. I currently have a kind of standalone cooler for my or liquid cool setup for my processor. It's just one of those you can buy at like Newegg or whatever. That's it's completely it's a closed loop. It's got the radiator. You can screw on the fan to the radiator, and you screw that onto one of the fan slots on your chassis, and then of course put the little circular heat sink thing over your processor, lock it down. Yep, it runs great. There have been a few instances where I've seen it a little higher than I like, but I mean it's bound, the coolant can only, like, as the coolant heats up, it's the fan can only cool it off so much. But yeah, and as I installed mods onto my little standalone Minecraft, just regular Minecraft, I had actually gotten a mod installer to actually install the mods for me or whatever. 'Cause installing Forge, I've wanted to install it, but it's just it's one of those headaches. That I don't want to have to deal with. So the mod loader did it for me, and then I'd add a couple mods, and then it would, if it didn't load, it would say, what the problem is, and so I would close Minecraft, download whatever mod I needed, whatever prerequisites that I needed for whatever mod. And or took a mod out that just that may not have been not have had a prerequisite out yet for 1.12.2, and then after I actually got it working, I got all the mods that have been updated to 1.12.2. I went in and Then I found out Direwolf had come out with this 1.12.2 pack, and I was just like, how dare they? How dare I not pay attention? And so then I just started playing that, and I'm actually thinking about, in fact, I'll probably record a video on that. I've actually already started a world. I've gone through the really just the rough bits of actually getting resources. I got, of course, the Tinker's Construct smeltery all set up and got me a house. And I don't know if I'm going to be able to record, a modern Minecraft thing, because I'm already, like, sometimes it actually gets a little laggy, just with modern Minecraft. And I actually figured out one of the, like, the main issue that I was having, let me cross into this lane, was I was getting this, because once I put all the mods in the my own standalone little mod pack I threw together, I was having this, I only had like 1 to 2 FPS, it wouldn't go beyond that, no matter what I tried. And then, so I started twerking the, or, you know, messing with the settings inside Minecraft, the video settings and whatnot, and I put, you know, particles to none, or to minimum. I even brought down the render distance down to like one chunk, which was, like, kind of weird. And I had the, of course, I leave FPS, max FPS to unlimited, because, you know, normal Minecraft, I can get over, like, 500-600 FPS at times, and, most of the time, in fact, but I don't know what it is about modern Minecraft, like, it just adds so much to the game. And some of my problems was I had to keep adding RAM to the game, and so I went from, like, I think default it's like 1 gig or 2, I added 5, and then I added I think it was like immersive engineering, and that just, like, boom, max RAM already. So I took like 5 minutes to actually get out of my save world, out of the game, and then add some more RAM. I gave it 10 gigs, you know, to have a good amount. And then I think I ended up, about the one big thing, well, one was you gotta make sure you allocate enough RAM. Of course, I got 32 gigs, so I can give it 15 if I need to, probably 20, without, you know, hurting my system. But I, under the, I think it's like, something that, it's a mini-map, can't even remember, it's mini map layers, I think it is, and like by default it's automatically set to 4. I can effectively run it with just 1, but at 4 it lags out the game. You get nothing, but like at one point I couldn't get above 0 FPS literally, and I had to just go into Windows Task Manager and shut Minecraft down, because I couldn't do anything. It was that bad. So I set it to 0, the minimap layers to 0, and then I tested it at 1, and I can do 1 so far. I haven't tested it past that, but I'm working on it, and I would like to get Optifine, because that really, really helps kind of make your computer run Minecraft way more efficiently and whatnot, and or make Minecraft more video efficient, basically. Is anybody coming? Because I think I'm gonna have to pass this guy. I'm creeping up on him. Yep. Alrighty, so let's get over. And I need to keep an eye on my gas. I'm at half a tank. Stay on the road. So after that, because there's several mods I actually wanted that I couldn't get, because they weren't updated. And like Ender.io, EnderZoo, and all that, the whole Ender suite, I'll just call it that. Of course, it's a really big mod, it's huge. So I ended up just started playing Direwolf, the Direwolf 20 pack, which is I always love watching Direwolf 20's Let's Play videos, his Forge Craft videos, and all that. Just, oh, they're so good. And it's a wealth of information of how to do stuff. Where's this guy at? Oh, is he really that far back? Dang. These cars need to get a move on it. I'm creeping up on this guy. Guy, do not get in my lane, and I am going way faster than anybody else, it seems like. I don't know why. Okay. Now everybody else is speeding past me. It's a fact of life in ATS. But, so yeah, I started playing Direwolf 20's pack, and then I actually added a few mods from what I had collected in my little mod pack. I can go a little slower. There we go. And I think I added, like, I don't know if immerse. I added, oh yes, I added mechanism, which adds a bunch of machines and stuff. And that made it real laggy, but I managed to. I think I needed more RAM, so I had to go into the launcher and add more RAM. So it's good now. I haven't tried to actually record. Times I have actually tried to record, I kind of freaked out there when I saw that car, and then I saw the exit, and I thought he might throw himself in front of me. But yeah, I haven't ever. The times I have tried recording modded Minecraft videos, it's my lag went way up, which made it like the videos were just garbage. But hopefully, if anything, should I try to contact Direwolf and see how he gets his how he gets by with such smooth FPS. I've never talked to him or anything, but and I ain't, sponsoring him or anything like that. It's just I've played like the Direwolf pack. I've played I think the Goods, whatever they call it. Their pack, I'll just call that. And probably, I'm sure. Oh, the Bevo Tech Pack, which is a 1.7.10 kind of specialty. Oh, oops. But yeah. How fast am I going? 69. Yeah, I'm doing good. Oh, so I can't go 70. All right, let's go that one. Actually, I can go about 6 miles per hour faster, and I just missed my exit. Dadgummit. Is there any car coming? I hate doing this, but I got to. Sorry, people. I had to. Then I gotta do it again to get back over there. Okay, come on, baby. You can do it. Go, go, go. Go, big hefty. Man, I was going 72. But I'll get back up to speed. Let me just find this. No, there we go. Oh, there's trouble up ahead. Oh, cool. That's awesome. I have never seen that in this game so far. Oh, jeez. There's a. Oh. Okay. Am I gonna miss? Yes. Yay. There we go. Centered my camera up, and we are on our way. And voila. Let's see, where are we? We're almost there. Awesome. It seems so much. Oops. Okay, there we go. It seems so far away, but now that I actually have something to talk about. I've always liked modded Minecraft over Minecraft. Just Minecraft just when I first When my brother, he actually got me into Minecraft. First got me into it, so I was, interested and whatnot, and then as I played it, it's just like, eh. Because that was back in the pre or the alpha or betas or whatever, and I think they had just, I think I started right before they created a bed, and then like the next update they created a bed, and I was just like, oh, sweet, and whatnot, but they have come so far, and they got a long way. They got a lot of more stuff they can be adding, and I think they're slowly like getting ideas from, I think, modders and whatnot. They'll kind of pick and choose. They're trying not to, take over. They're not taking anything exactly from any specific mod. But like, they've got hoppers now, which is awesome. Because that was just a much needed thing. I think they should add backpacks, honestly, because that's just, your inventory just is, it's never enough. In modern Minecraft, geez, you need like, I'm actually about to make like a mining backpack so that all the anything I, or at least all the ores that it knows to actually put in to a backpack, it will. And there's probably still some ores that, because there's anytime I do a modded Minecraft world or whatever, there's always some ores that they haven't added, so they don't go into a, one of the backpacks or whatever. But I'll like get a ender pouch or something for tools and whatnot. And I've actually I've gotten a mining turtle to start mining out from. Like, I'll plop it down a few blocks below my house and have it do like excavate 10, and it'll excavate 10 by 10 all the way down to bedrock, which is awesome. And so I have these big like silos in the ground underneath my base, and I'll usually try to add something like where the empty space is. Like yesterday I made a first layer, or put a layer down and started adding a farm, and eventually I want to actually automate that, put like a forestry farm. I've been looking up, because I want to get like, make, peat bogs and whatnot, but the Tilbury and all those little machines and doohickeys, they're not like in the actual mod pack that like you get, or in the mod, in the forestry mod. Supposed to be, but I don't know. I don't know if that's like an add-on or if that's a core mod. I've played a lot of mod packs with forestry, and after like, I don't know, was it 1.7.10? I couldn't find, or like it, the turbary and all those little, the woodcutter or whatever, the lumber mill or whatever they call them now. Didn't seem. Don't slow down like that, dude. Didn't seem to like they're not in the thing. You could do the multi-block farms, which you make like a, it's like a 3x3, 3x3 length and width, and then like I think it's 5 or 6 deep, like of farm blocks of like a certain. Like what I'm doing right now, in my world, is I was slowly making those farm blocks, the really first ones, which are stone bricks. There's several different versions which make different farms and whatnot. What is, okay, there's no one over there. Let's go. There we go. I had to reset my camera, and gosh, it is just dark out here. And I ran out of tin, so I kind of put that on the back burner and kind of been doing little off and on jobs. I'll need like sand, so I'll have to go get sand and whatnot. This and that and the other. I made a good pick. A lumber. It's a really good Tinker's Construct axe. the pick is a Tinker's Construct too, and then the excavator, which is, you know, digging a 3x3, which is awesome. And I used I can't remember what resource it was or what material it was that actually it, water doesn't affect it, so I can actually mine like clay or dirt and sand while underwater, and it does the same. It does it just as fast as what it does above water, which is awesome. And but I was running out of breath, so I was like, you know what, this is getting annoying, because it has morph, which lets you, like, any animal or anything you kill in the game, you can turn into it. So I, you know, killed a squid early on, and it's like, hey, I'll turn into a squid, I should have, you know, unlimited breathing. No. I killed a bat thinking I'd be able to fly, and I think I maybe have to change the settings on the actual mod or something. I don't know, because it's not like you're not getting the abilities of those creatures. Like, I can't fly as a bat, even though I've flown plenty of times as a bat. So I don't know if the like the there's a setting that just turns off the abilities or what. I tried to look into it, but haven't had any luck yet. But I only looked briefly. Let's see. I've been wanting to make a Tinker's Construct hammer, but now that I've got a turtle, I'm like, there's not really any point other than, like, if I need to go just manually find, you know, an ore or whatever, I can just start tunneling a 3x3 in whatever direction. I've got, like, I think 3 diamonds and I'm saving them up. 3 or 2. I know I had, like, I made a diamond pig so I could make a turtle, so that was 3. I think I may have had 6, and I think I have 3 left. Somewhere around there. But, the mining turtle, oh, jeez, it just helps so much. Let's see, do I have to turn off here? No. But I do need gas very quickly. Where's the nearest gas stop? Sweet, there's gas right up ahead. Awesome. Okay, sorry for that. My nephew is being obnoxious. Okay, oh jeez, stay in your lane. Probably shouldn't speed up. But, you know what, I'm just going to stay at this speed. I'm going to put my brights on just so I can see, because this area is a bit windy. Is that? Oh no, that must be that, I see, okay. Cool beans. And yes, I'm going to get in this lane. Oh, nope, I saw the barrier and thought I was going to turn, but no. Not quite, it's right up here though. I hate these curves. Okay, yes, I am gonna turn off here. Just slow way down. I'm gonna have to excuse my nephew for the being kinda rude. Anyways. Yay, gas. Let me cut my brights off so you can actually see the gas station. Okay, then cut it hard. Don't want to hit the sign or the pumps. Oh, yay. I can rest my pinky and use one of my other fingers. I just cut my engine off twice. Oh jeez, that's another thing I gotta watch out for. There's people cutting out from there, and great, how am I gonna do this? This is gonna be complicated. I'm gonna pull way out, and come on person. Dang it, there's another car coming. And I can't see around this sign. I'm actually gonna kinda turn so I can turn more effectively once this... Don't stop, keep coming. I'm coming. Alright, here we go. There better not be anybody coming. I'm sorry about your sign, but there was no way. Not with that RV to my right. No! Really immovable objects. I hate them. Swing wide. These are immovable too, I'm sure. Okay, there we go. Dang it, yeah. Wow, I didn't do any damage to my vehicle or the load. Awesome. Okay, here we go. Off we go. Oh, it's Springfield, huh? Cool. Alrighty, let's hit our turn signal. Make the turn. There we go. Heave! Turn my left turn signal on. Okay, just making sure my camera is centered. Let's take off. Okay, we're up to speed. Now I can talk. I try to give my pinky a rest as much as possible. So I'm gonna try to record Minecraft, but if I can't, I can't. Just gonna put it at that. If Minecraft because it all depends on the FPS is high enough. And if it's, you know, smooth, which there's a lot of times it's not. Which, I think it's, so far it's been the highest I've had in several Minecraft worlds, or modded Minecraft worlds, that is. It's actually been, I think I saw 60 yesterday, 60 FPS. Of course, it doesn't stay there. If you have a lot of machines, which I haven't gotten a lot of machines yet, but there's several factors that can make it lag, and I've got to stay in my lane. Okay. I'm gonna move over, since I'm gonna be passing this guy in a minute. We must be going uphill, because I'm doing 60. 58, no! Go faster. Just got off my cruise control. No! This must be a long hill. Oh, it is. Yay, we're almost to the top. Yep. Oh, now we're increasing speed. Awesome. Come on, you can do it. Faster, faster, faster. And if need be, I just won't record when my nephew's in the room. Just have to record like in the mornings, and actually not in the mornings, because I'm going to be starting a new job starting tomorrow. I think that's 8 to 5, I believe. There we go. Okay. Can go a few. Like, I think it's about 4 miles an hour over the speed limit, so. Yeah, we're doing good. Oh, where are we? Oklahoma! Native America. Cool. Awesome. Wow, it's amazing how far. It seems to illuminate more on the left side. I don't know if that's just me. It's probably just because I'm in the left side of the truck. because it illuminates way over into the other lane. Well, I don't know. I think it's just me, because it illuminates way off the road too. Quit. Oh, jeez, I almost went off the road because of my nephew. Okay. How far? Almost there. Okay. Is that another vehicle? Yeah, I'm gonna get in the right lane anyway. I hate using the keyboard due to it's you have to like constantly like adjust. But I'll eventually get my wheel out of the garage. Try not to spread myself too thin on like, because I've got like several different series out right now. Like, I've got this one, Factorio, Space Engineers, and I have no clue if I'm gonna be able to record Minecraft, or at least modded Minecraft. I can record regular Minecraft, but it's just not into that. It's gotta have machines and technical stuff. It's gotta be complicated. The only way that it entertains me. I like putting things together and making all these machines and whatnot. Now that they have like things like immersive engineering and like mechanism where you have multi-block. Oh boy. Oh my gosh. I am. Okay. There we go. Okay. I gotta get over. Oh wow. Just in time too. See anybody? Let's go. Go, go, go. Oh, jeez. Don't run into the... Don't run into anything. There we go. Okie dokie. Really? Really? There was no way for me to stop. That's great. Can I back up? Okay, yes. Great. See, that is why I hate this game. It'll screw you over every time. Like here, I was picking up speed and everything was cool. Was that really just one engine? If that is what the trains are in this game is, that's sad. And you just damaged my load for one engine. That's pretty... It's pretty redonkulous, if you ask me. Okie dokie. Yes, I know you're tired. Shut up. Come on. Come on, green light. There we go. Oh, look, there's another popo. Too many popo. Don't you dare do it. Don't you dare do it. You'll put me in a mood I don't want to be in. Just kidding. Oh, jeez. I hate those little X's. Like, I see him, but like, I don't know. I don't pay attention. little X's are so annoying. That's one thing I hate about the game. But you can actually run into them and not do any damage, which is, that makes it good. That makes it okay for me, in my opinion. Yay, green light. And here we are. Right, where do we turn in? Do not tell me I gotta turn in the, wait, where? Oh, is it? I apparently missed it completely. No. I'm gonna have to freaking do a U-turn. There's a car coming. What did I, really? How did I hit you? Don't even know. Don't even think about it. Please don't bother me. I'm in the middle of a turn, and you ain't gonna mess with me. Okay. Here we are. Oh, I didn't even see this entrance. It's so small. Like, heads up, police. We'll be coming your way. Hey, I made it. There we go. Jeez. Alrighty. Okay, so let's squeeze through here, try to get as far to the left as possible. Yes. Oh, jeez, I do not like this one. Got this big area here, but you gotta come over here to park. Yes, let's go over the curve. Go over that curve too. Yeah. And then whip around. Straighten way out over here. Here. Okay. I gotta use this. Oh. Oh. Okay, let's straighten up. I'm gonna try to use. Yeah, have to be this side. Wait, I need to get. Okay. We get around this corner first. There we go. I'm scraping it as I do. Alrighty. We're good. Now let's pull up. Oh. Oh, okay, that's one of those. Oh, it's a steamroller. I was wondering. It's like, what kind of heavy equipment is that? Okay, we're in at the back. Easy. Okay, no. I am not in the front yet. I want to be perfect. There we go, and voila. And if I don't get 90 experience, I'm gonna be mad. Okay, yay. Let's see. For parking the trailer, 90, yes. But of course, I did damage on that stupid train guard thing. Minus 1800 and minus 110 XP. But anyways, that's it. So, thank you for watching. Flammable explosive. I think I'm just gonna go with the high value, I reckon. Or actually, no, fuel economy. There we go. Yes. So, thank you for watching, and see you in the next episode. See you later.